அழித்திடவும் ஒருக்கிடவும் இரட்டிடவும் நீ ஆழ்வாய், கரைத்திடும் நாட்டினில் வாழ்கின்ற மன குரங்கு காட்டினின் குரங்கள்லாவும் கூட்டினில் நீ விரட்டி குணமாயறிந்து நீயும் விரிந்து நீ பாரடா மனமே, நீ வீதங்களை கூறாடா தினமே, அறிந்து நீ பாரடம் அன்றை அதை ஆராய்ந்து கொள்ளடா நெஞ்சில், விரிந்து நீ ஆடடா அங்கு அந்த விதங்களோடு பாடடா மனமே. நல்ல வழி கிடுமாகும் மனம் நாட்டிலேயே வழி கூடும், உண்மையோடு மனம் நீயும் உறவாடடாய.
In the name of God, most merciful, most compassionate.
Amen.
அளவற்றருளாளனும்
நிகரட்டன்புடையவனுமாய் ஆண்டவன்
மே ஆல்
சகல பொறுப்புகளும் பொறுப்பாகட்டும்.
May all praise and all responsibility be to that one God who is limitless grace and incomparable love. Amen.
கிருபையும் நன்மையும் அன்பும் செய்யும் அந்த ஒருவனுக்கே, நம் பிதாவுக்கே, எங்களுடைய வாழ்க்கையின் சிறப்பும் உயர்வும் தாழ்வும் அவனுக்கே பொறுப்பாக. ஆமீன்.
மே த ஸ்பிளெண்டர் ஆஃப் அவர் லைஃப், the high and the low in our life, may all this belong to that one God, Almighty One, our Father, who is goodness, who is love, who is compassionate beneficence. Amen. My very precious children, jewel lights of my eyes, children born with me as a life within my life, children who are the love within my heart,
அறிவுக்குள் அறிவாக என்னோடு அன்பு வைத்த, அன்பு கலந்த, அன்புக்குள் உறைந்த என் அன்புள்ள பிள்ளைகள் எல்லோருக்கும்,
டு ஆல் ஆஃப் மை சில்ட்ரன் ஹூ ஆர் த லவ் வித்இன் மை லவ், ஹூ டுவெல் வித்இன் மை லவ், ஹூ ஆர் த விஸ்டம் வித்இன் மை விஸ்டம்,
எங்களுடைய வாழ்க்கையின் சிறப்பையும் உயர்வையும், எங்களுடைய வாழ்க்கையின் சிறப்பையும் உயர்வையும் நல்ல குணங்களையும் செயல்களுக்கும் ஆண்டவனே பொறுப்பேற்று எங்களை பாதுகாத்தார். ஆமீன்.
மே காட் அலோன் ப்ரொடெக்ட் அஸ் அண்ட் பிளெஸ் அஸ் இன் திஸ் லைஃப், இன் அவர் லைஃப் ஆஃப் எக்ஸால்டட்னஸ் எக்ஸலன்ஸ் அண்ட் ப்ரொடெக்ட் அஸ் வித் ஹிஸ் கிரேஸ். ஆமீன். மை வெரி ப்ரெஷஸ் சில்ட்ரன், ஐ கிவ் யூ மை லவ். My very precious children who are the life within my life,
நாம் இங்கே வந்து இறைநம் பிதாவிலே இருந்து தான் இங்கே வந்திருக்கோம்.
We have come here to this world, but we came from our Father who is God.
So ஒளிவாக இருக்கும் போது நம் பிதாவை நாம் தெரிந்திருக்கும்.
When we were in that state of light, where the soul was in light form, we knew our Father.
ஒளிவா இருக்கும் போது ஒளிவு ஒளிவை கண்டு அதோடு தாழ்வணிந்து வணங்கி அவளுக்கு சங்க செய்த உடல் நம்மளிடத்தில் இருக்கிறார்.
When we were in that light form as the soul, the light saw the light, which was the source, and bent low in obeisance, reverential obeisance.
அதுதான் ஒரு மர்மமான ரகசியம்.
And that same body is still within us as a mystery secret.
அந்த மர்மமான ரகசிய உடம்பை தான்
இட் இஸ் தட் மிஸ்டீரியஸ் லைட் பாடி
அட்டம்
விச் இஸ் லைக் அன் அட்டம்
ரேஸ்
லைக் அ ரே அன் அட்டாமிக் ரே
மர்மம்
விச் இஸ் அ மிஸ்டரி வித் இன்
சீக்ரெட்
இட் இஸ் அ சீக்ரெட்
சோல்
மிஸ்டரி தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அ சோல்
லைட்
இட் இஸ் இன் லைட் ஃபார்ம்
அது ஒரு அறிவு
இட் இஸ் அ ரே ஆஃப் லைட் இட் இஸ் விஸ்டம்
அந்த அறிவான பொருளாக அது ஒரு அன்பு மயத்திலே அவன் அன்புலே விளங்கப்படுகின்றது
இட் இஸ் அ இட் இஸ் அ விஸ்டம் இட் இஸ் அ ரே ஆஃப் லைட் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் சீன் இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் லவ் த லவ் ஆஃப் அவர் ஃபாதர்
இன் த சோல்
அண்ட் திஸ் சோல் விச் இஸ் அ ரே ஆஃப் லைட்
ஃபார்ம் லைட் ஃபார்ம்
தட் இஸ் வீ ஹாவ் அ ஃபார்ம் இன்சைட் அஸ் அ லைட் ஃபார்ம்
இறைவன் மர்மம்
திஸ் இஸ் அ மிஸ்டரி நோன் ஓன்லி டு காட்
வாழ்க்கை இறைவன் வாழ்க்கை
And the life of that light form is God's life.
And shayal,
God's qualities. And the actions of this light form
and the anbu,
are the actions of God. The love that this light form exhibits is a limitless, infinite love that knows no separation or farewell from God. And that form, its actions, its behavior, its qualities with those compassionate qualities, it is with that in that form that we came here when we came originally from our Father. And that is a mysterious secret within us. It is that love that makes us instinctively show compassion on other lives, even without our being aware of it. It makes us aware, it demonstrates to us, it makes us go and soothe someone and comfort them. And this quality called compassion is one aspect of the qualities of that light form. And it is for us to realize this love
iravanila ulla or res anbu anbu kuravillada anbule or res
so this love this compassionate love that we feel sometimes is merely a ray from that infinite love which is God's love and we have that compassionate love within us
nam vaithirukku
we have that quality of compassion within us
anda olivai nam vaithirukku
And we also have that light, resplendent light within us. We have those actions of wanting to show compassion on others. And we have that light, the ray of light. And we have the life, which is the soul. We also have that grace that came from God. And we have that wisdom that came from Him. And therefore we have God, that God within us.
And the secret, the story,
and therefore we see that we contain the secret of that kingdom of God within us. My very precious children, it is necessary for us to understand this. My very precious children, now when we say love, what does it mean? All the love that we think is love, say we have love for a tree, even a tree, but that is selfishness, selfish love. We bring up a cow, we have a lot of love for the cow. Why? For selfish reasons. We bring up a horse. What sort of love do we have for that horse? That is selfishness. Why? Because it is my property. We bring up a dog, and because it is my dog, I have love for it, that is also selfishness. We look after a garden, or we bring up a fruit tree, or we have a cat in the house, or we bring up fish. No matter what we may have or bring up, the reason is selfish love. So the love that we have is selfish love. This kind of love, say we have a friend. We have a reason for having that friend. That love is selfish love. A friend, a house, whatever it may be, the cause is selfishness. Whatever love we show is selfish love. No matter what we may hold, whatever we may have. If we examine that love clearly, we will find that it is love with a reason. A selfish kind of love. Expecting something. Even if we hold on to a religion or a certain doctrine, no matter what, or we hold on to some racial fanaticism, always, if we look at it carefully, we find that there is a reason behind our feelings for those things.
And like this,
all the different kinds of love that we show someone or that we see have to be understood. Now, does this kind of love benefit us?
No.
The only love that is beneficial is selfless love, where there is no selfish love.
அந்த அன்பு
that love
நாம் என்ன வந்ததை உணர்ந்து
if we can realize what that kind of love
எதை
is
நாம் வளர்க்கின்றோமோ தொடுகின்றோமோ
whatever we மாடு, raise
ஆடு,
or touch
குதிரை, நாய்,
cattle
கூடை, எலி, வீடு,
dog,
வாசல்,
cat,
சொத்து,
house, property, possessions
படிப்பு, பட்டம், பதவி
learning, titles,
political
fame
ஞானம்,
political status even jnanam, what we call wisdom. Whatever it is that we desire and love, if the love is directed towards something and rests on something, it is a love that can release itself, that can be lost. That love is not like the fruit. Not a love that is intrinsically within, in the way that a fragrance is within a flower.
கல்லை ரோட்டில போட்டு அதை மிஷின் போட்டு மோல் போட்டு அதை அமுக்கி அதுக்கு தார் போட்டு நல்ல மெத்த மாதிரி வைத்திருந்தால்
suppose we spread gravel on the road, roll it down, crush it flat and cover it with tar and make it perfectly plain and level,
காலத்துக்கு காத்து வரும்.
Then in the course of time there will be
snow,
rain, there will be snow, there will be trucks riding over the road, there will be flood waters running over the road. And when these things happen in the course of time, the gravel, the stones crack and you will find what you call ruts or potholes on the road. So that the road was nice and flat only for a short while. But when the seasons changed, the potholes came. And when the potholes appear, what happened? When good things fall into those holes, they will break. If the wheel of a car goes into that, the axle might break. Or the tire might be punctured. Something will give way. So then the car breaks or whatever else goes over it. Similarly, all these selfish kinds of love in the course of the change of seasons, when the time changes, they tend to break in the same way as this road. Because we create that love like that road with a certain purpose. My very precious children, in the same way, whatever love we foster within us with a selfish motive, all those kinds of love break down at some time or other. Unless that love has a connection to God and truth, and justice, unless it is connected with God's grace and God's justice, any other kind of love always is in danger of breaking down. In the same way, my very precious children, all the love that is shown among all the creations of God, including the human generation, the love is exactly
like this. அல்ல இறைவனிடம் பலன் கேட்கவோ.
If we set out to follow God or worship God or ask God for benefits through this kind of love,
சொத்து கேட்கவோ, வீடு கேட்கவோ, அல்லது வாசம் கேட்கவோ,
if we ask God for property or money or possessions, or if we ask for a child,
அல்லது பதவி கேட்கவோ, அல்லது ராஜ்யம் கேட்கவோ,
for elevated titles or to rule a kingdom or even for heaven,
அன்பு வைப்பமானால் இறைவன் மீது,
if we placed his love on God with a certain purpose, with a certain motive, that love is what is called a broken love. It will break down. God is limitless grace and incomparable love. His God's love has no selfishness. He is compassion. His conduct, his qualities, his goodness, his love. He devotes his compassionate qualities on all lives. He lives within all lives. And he does his duty towards every life, knowing the heart of each life, knowing the qualities of each life. He protects them, knowing their conduct and their behavior. In this way, my very precious children, this love, which is God's love, must form within us. God's love must form within the human heart. His love must form within our hearts. And that state must form as a small fetus, an embryo within our heart.
அந்த அன்பை வெட்டி பார்த்து சரியான முறையில் குறையாதபடி தகுதியானபடி அதை நிரப்பமாக எடுக்க வேண்டும் என்றான்.
Whatever love we place on anything, we must splice it open, examine it carefully and make it a love that is complete and without any fault or shortcoming.
மனிதனுக்கு மனிதனுக்கும் உள்ள அன்பு,
the love
இறைவனுக்கும் இறைவனுக்கும் மனிதனுக்கும் உள்ள அன்பு,
between man and man and the love between man and God must be a unity kind of love.
அன்பும் அன்பும் கலக்க,
the love must merge, grace and grace must merge, qualities and qualities must coincide, actions and actions must be the same.
அருளும் அருளும் ஒன்று கூடவே,
the grace here and the grace there must merge as one, and this fragrance and that fragrance must merge as one. Just as the fragrance and the flower are one heart and the other heart must mingle as one. Only this kind of love can be called love. And it is only this kind of love that can give that fragrance, that delicious fragrance. And we, every child, must realize this state. When we place our faith in God, when we do our duty towards other children, when we do duty towards the human generation, whatever duty we set out to do without any attachment, without any selfishness, in the proper way, without expecting any reward, merely because man is man, that man is a prince of God, and with the belief, firm belief, that we are one family, that all human beings are our brothers and sisters, feeling another suffering of another as our suffering, the sorrow of another as our sorrow, an illness that another one feels as our illness, another one's hurt as our hurt, another one's hunger as our hunger, and treating the life of another as our very life, and his comfort as our comfort. And my very precious children, it is a love that melts in this manner that is true love. When we realize the suffering of others as our own, if we place the love that we place on a tree and transfer it to a man, how good is it going to be? Is that love? We bring up a teak tree with great love, but what happened? When the price goes up, we cut it down, don't we? We bring up a nice horse, but someone offers a good price for it, we'll sell that horse. We raise a cow as precious as our own life with a great deal of love, but someone offers a good price for that cow, we'll give it away. In the same way,
அதிலே நாம் ஒரு செல் பிசினஸ் ஆகிய அந்த அந்த பண்பை நாம் வைத்திருந்தோம். ஆனால்
வாட் எவர் இட் இஸ் தட் வி பிளேஸ் அவர் லவ் ஆன் அந்த நாங்க வித்து போறோம். இஃப் இட் இஸ் மோட்டிவேட்டட் டு செல்ஃபிஷ்னஸ் வி வில் கிவ் இட் அவே ஆர் செல் இட் அவே அண்ட் வி வில் ரிசீவ் நாம் வைக்கும் அன்பு ஓகண்டிலும் சிமிலர்லி
நாம் சிந்திக்கிறோம்.
We must reflect on the love we place on every different thing. Now let us see, when we look at the human generation as it is today, suppose a man takes a beautiful wife or a woman takes a beautiful husband and we have a beautiful child and we do so many things like this. And having done this, it is there certainly love
there.
And we call it two bodies but one heart at that time.
Self business.
But what is that love?
Enna anbu?
That is love born of selfishness. What is that love? It is a love for the body.
Enna anbu? Maya.
A love that is born of selfishness. A love that is born of maya or illusion.
Sila naal andha pennukku noi vandu vittal.
Then after a while, what will happen to this love? If the wife falls ill, the husband doesn't take care of the wife. That husband who said, we are one heart, all the two bodies, when she falls ill, he says, divorce. He doesn't want to look after her.
Divorce.
And the wife also might say, divorce.
இது போன்று பல எண்ணத்தின்படி நாம் செய்யும் அன்பு இது ஒரு அன்பா இது அல்ல அன்பு.
Is this what you can call love?
வாழ்வில பங்கு, நோயில பங்கு, செல்வத்தில பங்கு, பொருளில பங்கு, உடலில பங்கு.
There has to be a share in their life, in their illness, in their wealth, in whatever the suffering the body suffers.
சுகத்தில பங்கு, சுதந்திரத்தில பங்கு, எல்லாத்திலும் பங்கு.
There has to be a share in the happiness, in the joys and in the sorrows.
அன்புதான் அன்பு. பங்கெடுக்கும் அன்பு அன்பு.
Only when everything is shared can you call it true love.
இந்த நிலையில இல்லாத அன்பு.
But any love where the husband and the wife do not share these things alike is a love born of selfishness. That is a broken love.
அருமை கண்மணிகள்,
and this state, my very precious children,
அந்த அன்பு நிலை கூடும் போதே இதை நீங்க சிந்தித்து வெட்டி பார்த்து வெட்டி பார்த்து அன்போடு அன்பு அடையும்.
If you will examine your love at the time that you come together, if you will cut it open, examine it carefully, if you look for the love that is born of wisdom, love that is born of qualities and the action and the good behavior,
அன்பு தெளிந்தெடுக்கும் அன்பே அன்பு.
And the love that you get out of the clarity of all these things is true love. If you don't do this, any other love is merely love for the body, love for selfishness, love because we think of beauty and the property, or we look at the beauty of someone's learning.
சில காலத்துக்கு பின் அந்த அன்பை முறித்து விடுகிறதும்.
So when we show a love towards these things of beauty which are devoted to selfishness, very soon when those things of beauty change, we change too. We give up a girl and take another girl, or a woman gives up the husband and takes another husband. This is not true love.
சரியான பொய்ந்த அன்பு இரண்டு மனமும் உண்டாயி பூவும் மனம் போல் பொருந்த வேண்டிய
very precious children. True love is where both minds join as one, just as the fragrance is within a flower. So we must bring that love into our conduct, into our qualities. It's only when these qualities come together that true love will flourish.
Self business alla uyirku uyir business uyirku uyir undu kalappadum anbukku anbu undu kalappadum ponda anbai viswasikka.
Selfish love is not what we need. Must be a life for that life, love for that love.
ஒவ்வொண்டு ஒவ்வொண்டையும் இந்த அன்பை கொண்டு போய் இறைவனில் பொருத்துவது உண்டால் இறைவன் இந்த போல நாய்க்கு வச்சிருக்கிற அன்பை இறைவனில் வைத்தால் என்ன முடியும்?
It is that kind of love that we must grow within us. On the other hand, if we take the love that we have for a dog or for a cat and take that and say we love God with the same kind of love, is it going to help?
மாடு வைக்கும் போது இறைவனை விப்பீங்க.
When you sell the dog, you have to sell God too.
குதிரைக்கு வைத்திருக்கும் அன்பை
இறைவனில் வைக்க முடியும். When you place the love that you have for a cow on God, when you sell the cow, you will sell God. In the same way as you will sell God when you sell your precious
horse.
Can you place the love that you have for a dog on God? It seems funny.
அன்பண்டா என்ன வேண்டதை நீங்க தெரிந்தெடுத்துக் கொள்ளவனே நான்.
Therefore, we have to discover what love means and take that kind of love. What is the kind of love that we must place on God? What is the love that we must have for our life? What is the kind of love that two partners must have for each other? The love in their life must be the same as the fragrance is mingled within a flower. And what must the love be that we have for God?
ஒரு லைட்டும் லைட்டும் கலந்து கொள்ளும் ஒரு அந்த லைட் செல் அந்த தன்னலம் சரண்டர் அன்பு.
Our love for God must be that surrender,
அன்பு,
like one light.
அன்புக்கு அன்பு சரண்டர் ஆக.
Surrendering into a stronger light.
அறிவுக்கு
அறிவு சரண்டர் ஆக. Our love must surrender to that love, God's love.
அருளுக்கு அருள் சரண்டர்
ஆக. Our wisdom must surrender to God's wisdom.
குணத்துக்கு குணம் சரண்டர் ஆக.
Our grace must surrender to God's grace.
செயலுக்கு
செயல் qualities must surrender to His qualities. Our actions and our duties must surrender to His actions and His duties.
Life surrender.
That is, our life surrenders to that life.
Olive surrender.
Resplendence surrenders to that resplendence, that radiance.
Iravanukku iravan surrender.
Which means man must become God.
Iravan iravanukku surrender.
And that God must surrender to God.
இது போன்று surrender ஆகும் அன்புதான் இறைவனுடைய அன்பாக இருக்கு.
In this way, only the love that surrenders to that love is God's love. True love, that is the state of true love. But when we talk of love, we certainly have love for various things in various creations. We love the earth, we love the sun, we love the moon, we love the fire, we love our neck, we love the cow, we love the cat, we love trees, we love flowers. We have so much of love for so many things. What is there that we don't love?
Self-business anbu.
But all this is self-business love. We have to discard all these and discover what it is that is love for God. We must discover that unity. We must discover that love that should exist between a man and a woman. We must know that love that must exist between two human beings. We must have that love that knows that we are all one family, one race. We must know that we are one human generation, one race, one family. It is that love that we must discover and take. And to show that love in the way that a fragrance is mingled within a flower, that is true life. And the love, God's love, is a love that transcends all these kinds of love. That love, His qualities, His actions, His conduct, His patience,
His
tolerance, His peacefulness, His compassion, His inner patience, His surrender to the will of God. And His qualities of sympathy and giving, the feeling that all lives are as precious as His own, the feeling that all the hunger of all is like His own hunger. His love is a love that permeates all lives. And we must have that kind of love within us. We must form that love within us and surrender and make that love surrender to His love. My very precious children, all the time that we fail to create that love within us, until that wisdom is formed within us, until His compassion forms within us, until His actions grow within us, our love is that broken kind of love. It will be like this worldly love, the worldly love that we have for dogs and cats that we will love God with. The same love that we have for our racial differences, religious differences, love for our doctrine, the love for my things just as much as you love your things, love for money, love for wealth, saying my race and your race, my religion, your religion, these are the selfish kinds of love. Love with a reason, love with a motive. This cannot form a connection with God because this is broken love. It breaks here and there. My very precious children, we have to understand what it is that is love in our life, and we must form that love for God. The love that we place on God is a love that knows no comparison, no equal. It must be His love that we place on Him. It must be His grace that we place on Him. It is His compassion that we must have for Him. It is His conduct, His quality that we must show towards Him. So we must develop ourselves to that state and then place and give Him that love.
That is true surrender. Just as the fragrance is instilled within a flower, our soul and his mystery mingling together is love. Our ray falling into his light, that is love. My very precious children, what is our devotion to God? When we make our wisdom surrender to his wisdom, then we can learn. If we make our qualities surrender to his qualities, we can learn his qualities. If we surrender our life to him, we can learn about our life. If we surrender all our meanings, all our intentions to him, then we can learn about his meaning and his intentions.
My very precious children,
in this way we must bring his love and his actions to work within us. But as long as we have love for differences and trees and wealth and religions and philosophies and books and scriptures and say, I am the greatest. No, all the time that we say, mine, my possessions, my things, my relatives, as long as we hold on to these things, that is a love that can never merge with God's love, a broken love, like the love that we hold for dogs and cats. We have great love for a dog, but we lead it around on a chain. That is that kind of love. We have love for a horse, but we throw a reins and a bridle around it and ride on it. That is the kind of love that we have for the horse. We have love for a cow. Love for a mule, we load the mule with bundles on his back and we either ride it or walk along with it. What about a cow? We carry a big pail to draw its milk. That is the love we have for a cow. What is the love we have for a tree? We carry a sack or a truck to pluck the fruit from it. In this way, all the different kinds of love we hold for these things is with a reason, with a motive. In this way, we show different kinds of love to each. So it is this kind of love that we call love for self-business, the love of worldly life. If we don't want that thing, that love is broken. If we don't need that thing, our love is broken. If that thing does not have what we look for, that love is broken. This is the love that breaks. This is the love that sees divisions. So if we go on saying that we have love in our life, love for this and love for that, what kind of love are we talking about? My very precious children, we must split open the love that we have for each thing in our life, and if we see what is inside, we will see that in the tree and in the fruit and in the flower, in our life and in our sensual pleasures, in our gold and in our wealth and in the house and in the things we see with our eyes and the scenes that we see with our mind, we must open out each of these things and look within. And if we cut it open and look inside, finally we will see that there is only one kind of love, not this what we see outside. And that love is, my God, that wonder, that mystery wonder. When we see that wonder, we say, we exclaim, my God, that is the true love. The love that is within everything we see, at the central core of everything we see, is God. And we must realize that truth within us.
My God.
If we cut open everything we see in our life, finally what we see is, my God. That is true love. Whatever we want to learn or whatever we want to see, if we cut it open, go on cutting it, ultimately what we see, the fragrance and the light, is my God. When we split open everything we see in life, finally we see that one thing that permeates within all lives, that God who is seen as that ray, as that As that point, at the center of everything we cut open. And that point is that love.
And
if we see that love,
my God,
present within all lives, all creations, and it is to that love that we must have love. We say, oh my God, your creation, what a wonder. This is your creation, oh my God, what a wonder we say. This is your food, oh my God, what a wonder we say.
And
everything we cut open to see, we see only him as a great wonder within. If we want to show love, if we see love, we see only him. If we see wisdom, we see only him. If we see beauty, we see his beauty. When we see compassion, it is his compassion that we see. When we see actions, it is his action that we see. And when we see a miracle, it is him we see as the miracle. When we see a radiance, it is his radiance that we see. In this way, to see everything through him is that love that we must have, my very precious children. So the love that we must discover within each thing we look at, it is that love that we must find and discover. And we, if we can find that love and take it for ourselves, then everyone we see will be our brothers and sisters born with us. And that is the only kind of love where he is present. That is the only thing that is lasting, the grace, the wisdom and the light. That love is what shines as the beauty of our countenance. That is the beauty that exudes from our heart. It is the beauty of our wealth. That is the beauty of our life. And it is that love that makes our soul beautiful. And that is what makes the house of our life beautiful. My very precious children, the love of that beauty is true love. May every one of us reflect on that love. And may we, if we open our heart and look within with understanding, it is that love that we will see. In this way, if we open our hearts and look within, we must look at, open out everything we see and look within. Everything we understand, we must open. Even everything we eat, we must open out and look within. When we sleep, we must open and look within. Everything we see must be examined inside. And when we open and look inside, we will see his wonders, his miracles. Then we can see that love that dwells within all life. We can see that love that showers that compassion on all lives. And we'll say, my God, what a wonder. My very precious children, if we realize this, every child, every one of us must reflect on this. And we must take that love into our heart and use that love in our life. We must take those qualities and those actions and put them to action in our lives. We must demonstrate that beauty within us, and we must take that grace and the wisdom within us. And this is that love which is true love. That love born of that faith, born of that trust, the love that comes out of brotherly unity, the love in the belief that we are one family, the love of that prayer, that is the state in which we will merge with God. The love that knows no limits, the love that will never break. That is the love that will never fail. No matter what storms or gales, no matter what destruction comes on us, that is the love that will never be destroyed, a love that will never diminish. A love that will never change, a love that will never feel us, a love that will never falter. That is the true love, my children, my very precious children, every child. In all the things that you learn, in all the thoughts that you think, in all the wisdom that you learn, in all the understanding that you get, in all the feeling that you become aware of, and in the clarity that you receive, and in the prayers that you pray, in all the scenes that we see, in all the dreams that we see, and the way we conduct ourselves, whether it is day by day or by night, we have to open out everything we see at all times. Open, look, understand, and take that love, that truth, that justice, and that integrity and honesty, and the laws of righteousness. We must take all these and find them within that love, and conduct them in our lives. My very precious children, that state, my children born with me, you must discover the state of that love. And that is the love that will never perish. It, that is God's love. That is the love of His actions. And we must realize this. My very precious children, your lights are my eyes. In your faith, in your certitude and determination, in your wisdom and in your clarity, and as a clarity within clarity, as the wisdom within wisdom, as the divine wisdom within divine wisdom, as the grace within grace, and being as God within God, the love that mingled with God's love, as God within God, that is the true love, that is the actions of that love, my very precious children. How must we realize love and faith? And the action and behavior, how must we conduct them? How must we do our duty? How must we demonstrate our duty? How must we, in what way, must we realize and perform our prayer and worship? What must we mingle with? What must we lose ourselves in? What must we form a connection to and mingle with? So we must create the love that will mingle with that thing that we talked about. My very precious children, may we create that kind of love that will merge with Him. And if we want to create a fire, if we have oil and a wick, even though we have the oil and a wick, we need a matchstick, a flame, to light that wick. Only if we have the flame that we have the light and the heat from a lamp. Unless we have a lighted match, the oil will remain oil and the wick will remain wick. But when we apply the light, then oil plus wick plus the flame become the jyoti, the radiant light. My very precious children, our faith, the wisdom of that faith and our actions, our faith and wisdom of that faith and God's light must become one, must join as one. When all three join as one, His light comes and impinges on this wisdom. Only then will you get that light. And like this, my very precious children, so we must pour the oil called wisdom, we must have the wick of we must have the oil called faith and the wick called wisdom, and brings God's light to light this wick. And then that is the light that will dispel the darkness and display His grace. May we reflect on this. Like this, every child, if they will lay open their hearts, their kalbs, and lay open their actions and examine them inside, open your wisdom, open your conduct and look within. And then, my precious children, if you open them and look within, you will see that every nerve in everyone is your nerve. Every face that you see is your face. The blood in everyone will be like your blood. The illness in anyone else will be like your illness. All hunger will be your hunger. All poverty will be like your poverty. You will feel all sorrow as your sorrow. And all lives will be your life. You will feel everything in your nerves, in your looks, in your body. Will it not be like that? This is God's love. And when that state forms within you, that is God's love. That is true God's love. Because all suffering is His suffering. All sorrow is His sorrow. All hunger is in Him. All poverty is in Him. All grief is in Him. All suffering is in Him. Everything devolves on Him. That is how He does His duty. Like this. If you develop that love, your duty will be performed in that way. And if that love comes, you will not cause pain or hurt to any other life. You will not discard any life from you. You will not torture any other life. Because if you torture someone, cause hurt to someone else, it will be like hurting yourself. My very precious children, look at a tree. A tree may have 1,000 branches. And there are millions of leaves. There may be many millions of flowers. those flowers, those leaves, those branches. If you cut off one branch, it is a tree that feels the pain, is it not? Immediately the leaves will droop. Do they not droop immediately? The leaves droop immediately due to the pain. Look at the tree. Look at the tree, how the leaves droop in the sun. It is a tree that droops first and the leaves droop second. If a branch falls, it is a tree that feels the pain. Is that not so? A branch cannot fall off without the tree being aware of it. The leaves will not fade or drop without the tree being aware of it. It is from the tree that they fall. So the tree holds on to them, does it not? It is a tree that holds them. That there is like a glue that holds them. My very precious children. Even though there are so many millions of leaves and flowers, it is a tree that feels the pain, whether it is rain or sun or snow. In the same way, my precious children, when you realize yourselves, when you develop those qualities within you, then all of mankind will be like those leaves, glued or pasted onto you. All lives will be covering you. All suffering will be on you. All the blood of others, all the illness of others, all the hunger of others will be touching. As soon as you get those qualities, that God's love and God's qualities and God's action, everyone will be on you. And therefore, you will feel the suffering no matter which one it comes to. And when you develop that plenitude, that fullness, then all the suffering will be felt by you. Grief, pain, sorrow. My very precious children, think of that. If you can develop to that state as a tree did, a man with that wisdom, a man with those qualities, if that good man becomes one tree for the world, he will be one tree for the world of the soul and this world and the next world. He alone will know all the suffering in the entire world, because all suffering comes to him, all illness comes to him, all the grief of all the worlds come to him, all the hunger comes to him. Everything that is felt by every nerve, every skin, every muscle of everyone in all the world will be felt by him. It was in this state that God sent every prophet. God sent each prophet saying, go and accept this suffering, go and prevent this suffering. All the karmas of the world, all the sufferings of the world, to relieve them of the suffering, to preach wisdom, to make the light of wisdom shine so that the darkness of ignorance will be dispelled, and to take on the suffering of others. In this way, my very precious children, when we get to that state, then all suffering, all pain, all illness will have to be experienced by us. And at that state, everyone will be brothers, and we will see every illness within us. You must realize, my very precious children, God's love, the children's love. What does it mean? What does devotion or wisdom mean? What is the love that we have for God? What is the love that we have now? We must realize the difference. And if we can identify and discover this true love, then we will become that representative of God, as the light of God, as a light that merges with His light. And that means God will be merging with us. And at that time, the entire sorrows of all the worlds will be felt within us. We must realize this. My very precious children, jewel lights of my eyes, every child, please reflect on this. The love, our love, God's love, the love for all other children. How must we see this? What are they like? We must. And when we divide all this away, what do we finally see? God's love, brotherly love, love of justice, love of truth. God is love. May we reflect on this, my very precious children, your lights of my eye. Every child, reflect on this, understand with wisdom, and take on that love. Conduct yourself as God will conduct himself. Have God's love for all. May we bring that love into practice. Amen, amen. May this prayer be fulfilled.
Bawa is offering his present from God, that is from his father. Oh God, who is filled in my heart. Oh God, who is the fill of my heart. Oh, may we praise him with exaltedness. Oh, may we praise him with exaltedness. Oh, that God who is full in our hearts. The one of splendor, let us praise him. Let us intend that Almighty One. Oh, let us worship our Creator, the Mighty One. Oh, let us worship our Father who is of glory. That God who gives us peace in our hearts, let us worship him. Let us all unite and live together. Oh, let us all join at the feet of our God. Let us all unite together and live. Let us all fall at the feet of our Father and receive his grace. Let us join with that all compassionate one. Oh, let us worship that one God who is the light of our eyes. Oh, precious gems, do come. Oh, look at our primal Father. Oh, precious dwell light, do come. Oh, let us look at our eternal primal Father. Oh, open out your hearts and place him within. Oh, go on that pure path always. Oh, join with that Father who gives us bliss. Oh, gain victory in both lives and live. Oh, search for that one who gave our lives. Oh, believe that he is only one and live. Oh, let us all join that one who is the full in our thoughts. Oh, let us believe in that one God who is our glory and live. Oh, all my precious gem, do come. Oh, let us all join together and live with one God. Go to the one who is as life within our life. Let us all join with him from within and outside and live. Let us join with our Father. Let us all join together permanently, now and forever. Let us live as one. Oh, that God, let us prostrate to that God who is within our heart. எல்லாரும் ஒன்றாக கூடிடுவோம் let us all join together as one
இருளோக பாதுசாவையே வணங்கிடுவோம்
let us worship that lord of both worlds
என் இதயம் நிறைந்திடும் கண்மணியே
oh that gem of my eyes whose queen within my heart
நடந்திடுவோம்
let us all join and joint walk together
எங்கள் பிழைகளை எல்லாம் தகுத்திடுவோம்
let us cast away our evils
குணத்தை குணம் கொண்டு நடந்திடுவோம்
let us imbibe the qualities of god and
ஆன்ம ஜோதி அருளை பெற்றிடுவோம்
let us receive that jyothi of our soul
ஆதியும் கடந்தவனை நம்பி கூடிடுவோம்
let us believe in that one who has transcended beginning and end He is our only Father. Let us place Him within our hearts and worship Him. Let us discard our 4,10,000 sins. Let us do good deeds and spend our life. May He reside within our hearts. May He protect us as life within life. May He give you a precious life. May He give you Oh, the one of grace, would you do come now? Will you embrace all my precious children? Will you embrace them in your hearts and then show compassion? And may you protect them so the karma of life won't touch them. We need your grace in our heart. Oh God, what our help but you. We need that Iman, oh God. Oh, give your grace. May you grace us with a life without illness. May you bestow that wealth without any undiminishing. May you give us that right to live with you. Oh, you must give that happiness. We need your grace that we can understand our obligations and worship you. Oh, do come, O God,
here.
Oh, be our basic principle and look at us. Oh, open our hearts and be within. Oh, that Creator, the Almighty One, give your grace. Oh, in the hearts of every child. You must penetrate and give your grace. Oh, give them a life without any wavering. Oh, that Mannaman, the Almighty One, will you grace this? Amen. 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 Song, Father. I love to receive that.